Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2023 Manitoba Provincial Junior and Intermediate Honor Band Concert. I think that the warm-up bodes well for us listening to some really wonderful music from this group of students tonight. My name is Virginia Helmer, and I have the pleasure of being your MC. Music is an agent of hope, a dynamic and valuable device that helps us to heal and to bring us together. The First Peoples of Canada understood this and used music to reunite, resolve, and reconcile. In the spirit of reconciliation, we acknowledge that MBA activities take place on treaty territory, land that was maintained and earnestly cared for by Indigenous peoples before European settlement. Manitoba occupies the original lands of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene peoples, and is the homeland of the Métis Nation. We acknowledge that Winnipeg benefits daily from Treaty 3 water that comes from Shoal Lake 40. It is with sincere sentiment that we recognize the mistakes of our recent and distant past. In working towards a Canada that benefits us all, we commit to seeking a greater understanding of Canada's diverse cultural relationships through continued work with Indigenous communities. We commit to live in ways that honor and respect the treaties that were made on these territories, and we commit to stewarding the land in harmony will come after us. The MBA Honor Band program is offered at three levels, in addition to the junior and intermediate honor bands that you will hear this evening. A senior honor band is held the first weekend in November. The MBA Honor Band program dates back to 1979 with Paul Patterson conducting the first senior honor band at the Winnipeg Convention Center. The first junior honor band was in 1983 with Gavin Lewis conducting, and the first intermediate honor band started in 1997 with Gord Brock conducting. On stage first is the 2023 junior honor band with guest conductor Murray Lawrence. Let's give Mr. Lawrence and the honor band a warm welcome.
Thank you. Chesnokov was a devout Christian who wrote church materials prior to the Bolshevik Revolution. Since part of this revolution was the suppression of the church, writers such as Chesnokov were forced to stop writing sacred material, as the ideals of the church conflicted with the ideals of the new Soviet state. As a result, it is believed Chesnokov never heard this composition performed. The song reflects the turmoil he faced during that time, as well as the hope and salvation in which he believed.
The images that is visualized when one thinks about a painter is that of the palette, the board that he holds and mixes his paints on. It is from this palette that he expresses his thoughts through the images created. Palette by Randall Stambridge is a six-movement work where the musician expresses his thoughts using sound rather than paints to portray various emotions or settings. This evening, the Junior Honor Band will play four of these movements. They are Angry Red, Harvest Orange, Royal Purple, and Verdant Green.
Thank you.
He would like to speak to his wife.
Who are the parents of these kids? Raise your hands. Everybody put them together. They have done an outstanding job of raising outstanding children. Just over 48 hours ago, we started at the U of M. Nobody knew each other. They came in their little packs. I went home that night going, oh my goodness, I think I chose music that was too hard. I have never seen more dogged instrumentalists in my life. They have worked. We had a 6.5 hour day on Friday. And we had to literally chase them out of the room because they still wanted more. Absolutely phenomenal kids. Put them together for them already. Years ago on the first weekend of June was the first one of the junior high honor bands. Mark Oldera and Bill Christensen, I don't see them here this evening, and I had been to the senior concert and the idea bounced around, why don't we have one of these for the junior high kids? And Mark and Bill grabbed the bull by the horn and I jumped in and helped. The next year I did more of the work. We did the first concert, first rehearsals at the old Tashley Hall at U of M. I don't know if anybody remembers that old Tashley Hall. I think we had maybe 75 people in the audience. And we just threw out chairs around the band, and that's how formal it was. To see it over the decades we wrote in this is absolutely mind-numbing to me. Absolutely mind-numbing. And the number of volunteers over the years that have participated and helped from listening to tapes, moving equipment, to doing sectionals, and then we have a snowstorm in Saskatchewan, we have to do sectionals on Zoom. We have a committee that made up to get all this organized. Music is there. The amount of work, not just this year, but 40 years, just absolutely phenomenal. Cheryl, Daryl, and all of your committee, thank you for giving me this opportunity. This has been on my bucket list for quite a while. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to work with this quality group. I have lots of good memories. And let's go to our fourth tune.
Mr. Lawrence, thank you so much for teaching us over these past few days. The time and effort you have put into our band is much appreciated by us all. It was not always smooth sailing. We had to work hard to get to where we are, and you did threaten to throw shoes at our percussionists. But nonetheless, I speak for us all when I say it was amazing. It was an amazing week working with you. I would like to offer you this gift on behalf of everyone from this year's Manitoba Junior Honor Band.
Students, bravo, it's been a lot of fun so far. I hope you're having fun. If you've enjoyed this, and I think you have, I'd encourage you to consider coming to the International Music Camp this summer, because it's like this, but more. We have 6 weeks of summer student camp programming, mid-June through the end of July. Band, of course, is one of our most popular programs, but we've got all kinds of other things that students can explore as well. So I'd love for you to consider spending a bit of your summer with us down at the International Peace Gardens. And I do have a scholarship for one lucky student, whose name shall be drawn from, from the bag, and I'm going to ask our climbing tuba player here to reach in and pull out the lucky winner. Thank you. Mr. Lawrence, I'm afraid this is not for you. But you can come work at camp if you want. Always with great help. Kieran McConnick? Thank you so much.
Okay, so before we hear our last introduction by this fine young lady who's been waiting so long to give it, I will take this opportunity just to say how much I've enjoyed this performance, and I know that we are all going to enjoy your last piece. So one more round of applause, please, for you.
Thank you.
Congratulations, everybody. What a wonderful piece. I love that one. And bravo. We will now take a 15-minute intermission. Welcome back, everyone. Please join me in welcoming to the stage the intermediate honor band under the direction of Mr. Ross Brownlee. Thank you.
so very much for coming and for sending us these amazing, amazing children. We will talk a little bit more about them a little bit later. We'll save the best for last, of course. That was a tune by Winnipeg. He is an amazing gentleman. His name is Peter Meehan, and he writes from his heart with the greatest of musicality and with the greatest of passion, and he believes what he feels about music, and he's able to translate that into notes for people to play on their instruments. We were so fortunate yesterday that Peter came and spent an hour with these folks, which is kind of cool, because often we think about a composer, and I remember telling the kids when I was little, they were either dead or lived really far away, so it was not part of my life, and this is the truth, right? Many of them are not dead, and many of them live around here, and we're actually very fortunate in Manitoba, not only do you have great musicians, great students and great teachers, but also great composers. So it was kind of cool. Parents, ask your students about Peter and what his stories are about. Zenith is, and he explained this to us, is he had moved from England to Saskatchewan, and he just looked at this prairie, this land, this landscape with northern lights, storms, snow, and this sky, because he said in England, and it's true, I've been there, it's such a small place, and there's so many lights that the stars are obliterated. You can't find open space. So when he came here and he went out into a field, he was like, good God, what are all those lights up there? And they were the stars. So he wrote this piece for students to play and to be proud of the place they were from. And what an effective piece of music. So thanks to the students for doing that. We're going to change the style pretty nearly completely, for those who remember Monty Python, and now for something completely different, we're going to play a tango. This is just as the junior band talked about the arts connecting together music and painting with palette. Here, music is the accompaniment for dance. You can't really have dance without music, so we will play you a dance. The blue one. Thank you. Nemus Estado is just such a cool name. I was drawn to it. I also like Dutch composers. I went to Holland and I thought it was a pretty cool country and they had some great music. Jan van der Roest is from there, so I said, let's look at this. And it's an interesting piece. Nemu is actually part of an arts complex that Yamaha Music has, the Nemu Arts Facility. So a lot of the instruments in this band are Yamaha. And parents, you go out to your music store and probably you have a lot of Yamaha parts and you're happily supporting them by renting your instrument. Thank you for doing that. They make these things in Japan, and there are training facilities and a concert hall. And they host international festivals at this Nemu Hall. Jan van der Roest, back up to the 90s, was asked to commission a piece. Well, he happens to live in Antwerp, and 450 years earlier, there was another composer who lived in Antwerp by the name of Tielman Sasada. And I happen to really like Renaissance music, the time of that period. And Tielman Sasada, the early one from the 17th century, wrote an awful lot of dances for bands, very similar to this. They had winds, they had percussion, there were brass, there were some instruments that made some sounds we no longer have, and we have some instruments now that don't. So this guy, Jan van der Roest, said, okay, we're going to Japan, but I'm from Holland, let's take this early music and blend it with modern and put it together. We're doing it in Nemu, so it's Nemu Sasada. It's kind of a neat thing. It's a bit of a Renaissance dance in three parts. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
please, we have many, many thank yous. If we could have the lights up so that we can recognize some of the people that have played such an important journey in these students' journey to be here on the stage with you. Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the parents that are in front of us tonight. If you had not nurtured your children's love of music, good, so we're starting with parents, which is good because there's a lot of parents out here, so we'll just try that. Really, this doesn't happen by accident. There's a lot of support that goes into putting these kids on stage, from driving them around to lessons, or encouraging them when they're practicing, making sure they have an instrument that works. Thank you, parents, for all you do for your child. We have private teachers, we have band directors. Could I get everybody who has taught or influenced in an educational way the students on the stage and the students that played in the first band to stand up, please? All the band directors and private teachers. Organization, the Manitoba Band Association, that creates these opportunities for students. We have the chairs of our committees. So junior honor band chair is Mr. Daryl Ferguson. Big round of applause for Mr. Ferguson. Cheryl Ferguson is administrator tonight, but this is a person who does a lot to make this honor band happen, and you saw her up here at the beginning and moving the furniture and organizing the sectionals and making everything work, and for many years these people have been involved, and they deserve our huge gratitude, so thank you very much, Cheryl. We also had, and I need to look up these names to make sure I get them right, Fazil Shah, who is a custodian at the university, who went above and beyond the call of duty. By the way, that was a Jeopardy question the other day, words that have A, B, C, D in that order. Above and beyond the call of duty to make sure that the band had everything that they needed. And also Ellie Rattel, who helped out with percussion sectionals, and Victoria Sparks. Dr. Sparks is the percussion instructor down at the University of Manitoba and provided a lot of support and help to our percussionists. So thank you to all of those.
Hi, I'm Catherine. I'm in grade 10, and I play I would like to express my gratitude to our incredible conductor, Mr. Bramley, for all the time, energy, and dedication he has put into this band in the past few days. Your love and passion for music has created such an amazing experience for each one of us. Lastly, the band challenges you, Mr. Bramley, to conduct a piece without stopping. Thank you for everything.
I appreciate that, but it needs to be turned around here, because it was really, the gift was for me. To be given the opportunity, and you know, this is the second time you're going to hear it, because Murray Lawrence said the same thing. This is a gift, ladies and gentlemen. Your kids are phenomenal. They really are. To sit, that's a lot of music and a lot of time. You know, 9 till 4, and we only took a few breaks yesterday. Plus 4.5 hours the night before, and then, oh, let's take our Saturday and come out and play some more. This is a big dedication, and they never once faltered. And when the challenge was given, all right, let's do it. What a thrill. You know, we spend our lives going into band rooms and playing for four walls and the ceiling and the floor a lot. And those of us who do this craft, we're very fortunate people. And we thank whatever there is for the job that we got and for music, and it is a beautiful gift. But to have this opportunity with these amazing and wonderful students, and I think we hear it in the music, it's there. So I would like to thank them, and I'd like to thank the fine folks who organized all of this, and they are truly fine folks, the amount of details that go in, but for giving Murray Lawrence and myself this opportunity. What a gift. Thank you, and thanks. Way to go.
I wanted to let you know that the MBA also runs a summer band camp that happens in mid to late August. The dates are not set yet, but please keep an eye on our social media pages and the website, mbband.org, and get some more information. And of course, all these wonderful band directors will be sharing that information too. So without further ado, could I bring up Mr. Johnson?
Here once again, and students, bravo. It's been thrilling, and I hope you've had a lot of fun, because it's been a lot of fun for us out there. I love all the international connections, particularly in the intermediate program, because it got me thinking about why International Music Camp? Why is it named that? What does that mean? Yes, it straddles the 49th parallel, directly between Canada and the United States, and we have students and teachers who come from all over North America and converge on this amazing place every summer to make music and art together, and that is pretty cool. We also have students come from all across the globe, and some faculty as well. I think we've got 12 countries confirmed to join us at this point for the summer, which is great, especially as travel has opened up a whole lot this year. That was something that we've missed a little bit the last few years. So it's really a wonderful place to meet students, like-minded folks who love the same things, and we spend a week together doing that, which is really cool. But it's also a place where we can study music that maybe we have more to learn. We're really excited to be launching two new programs this summer. The first is a hip-hop dance intensive, and also an indigenous music and art program that will take place over a weekend in early June. So I encourage you to check that out. That program is for everyone. And I do have a scholarship here for one of the bandmates, but I would love for you all to come and consider spending a little bit of your summer with us. So let's draw the name. And since our trumpet player is close, he gets the honors.
Mr. Brownlee, are you going to say anything about this last piece? Or do you want me to say anything about this last piece?
Feel free to clap.
Yes, it's traditional Radetzky March. Thank you everybody for coming. Enjoy the rest of your evening.